Hello friends, you are watching Learn and Grow with Faraz, and my name is Faraz Bhatt. The topic that I have selected for today's discussion is Sustainable Development Goals. Although I know that the viewership for this topic is very limited, however, let me assure you that this is a topic of trendy discussion in many literary discourses and among many academicians. For my general viewers, let me assure you that this topic is going to be very informative, whereas the people, the viewers who are interested to contribute to work on sustainable development goals, this video is going to be very fruitful for them. One more important thing I want to share that I'll not cover all the 17 goals in one video in detail, because it's difficult to encompass all the goals in one video because they are quite wide and quite huge. So I'll discuss all the 17 in a nutshell in a small brief introduction. So I'll discuss those 17 goals in a simple and easy way. And afterward, this video will be followed by a series of videos where I'll cover each and every goal among the 17 in complete detail. At the end, I would like to pay my gratitude to the website of UNESCO because I compiled useful information from UNESCO website. Furthermore, I would also like to pay my gratitude to Dr. Asif Khurshid Mia, who is a big name in marketing, especially in academic and in research field in Pakistan. I also compiled some useful inputs from his work related to SDGs. So without a delay, let's go to the video and enjoy your learning. Okay, Sustainable Development Goals. Let me give you a brief introduction about SDGs. There are 17 in numbers. There are 17 goals which are followed by 169 targets. And how these goals emerge? This is a very important question. You might have heard about Millennium Development Goals. Let me tell you, in 2015, all the leaders of the world and the governments, they had a mutual discourse and they decided to transform the MDGs into SDGs, which is Sustainable Development Goals. So in 2015, the MDGs, they were transformed into Sustainable Development Goals. So we can also say that SDGs, they are an offshoot of Millennium Development Goals. So definitely United Nations was the main stakeholder which emphasized the importance of SDGs, and then they launched the 17 global goals across the globe, and all the governments, they are supposed to attain those goals till 2030. So this is a brief introduction of SDGs. Now watch from my screen that these are 17 in number, starting right from goal number 1, which says that there should be no poverty, and ending at partnership for the goals attainment. So there are 17 in numbers. In the coming slides, I'll explain each and every goal one by one. That is going to be very useful for my viewers. So let's move forward. And how does the name emerge? The formal name for the Sustainable Development Goals is in fact transforming our world. So this is very attractive to know. And till the 2030 agenda, the world needs to be transformed into a better position. So SDGs can be called as the transformation of a world into a better, developed and sustainable planet up till 2030. So this is the idea behind the name. So that has been shortlisted as SDGs. So these are goals in a nutshell you are watching on the screen. And like I told you about the targets, there are 169 in targets and 17 are the total number of goals. Okay, those SDGs, they are very comprehensive in their nature, and they cover all the issues which are pertaining to the society, not the issues which are pertaining right now, as well as the prospective issues which can be a problem for our society in the future. So they cover
economic, social, environmental, and all the other issues which can directly or indirectly impact our planet. I was telling about social, economical, so you can have a broader idea from different terms that they include the poverty, the issues related to hunger, the problems related to health, related to education, the environmental problems like global warming, some other issues which are pertaining to our gender inequality, the water, the sanitation system, sustainable energy, rapid urbanization, you know, a clean and neat environment, and social justice, a fair justice for everyone. Now, let's move to goal number one, which says that no poverty across the globe. So what is the punchline of this goal? This says that end poverty in all of its forms everywhere. Everywhere covers the whole planet from north to south. So this is the punchline for the goal number one, no poverty. Now move to the goal number two. Goal number two advocates about zero hunger. The goal number two is no hunger. You can remember after watching my video. So no hunger says that end hunger, achieve food security and improve nutrition, as well as promote sustainable agriculture system for our future generations. So this is the punchline for sustainable goal number two, which says that hunger should be eliminated and the agriculture system should be improved for our next generations. So now let's move to goal number three, which is a good health. And the bottom line for a good health, sustainable goal number three, is ensure healthy lives and promote well-being for all the ages, irrespective of the gender, irrespective of the caste and creed. So it talks about health and well-being of our future generation. Goal number four, this is one of my favorite goals. It calls the need for quality education. I am personally working on this goal, and this goal advocates that inclusive and equitable quality education is mandatory for our next generations. And in my personal capacity, in my personal opinion, this is the fundamental goal which can link all other goals towards its attainment. So this goal calls for provision of quality education right from our primary level to our graduate and postgraduate level. So it can ensure a sustainable, a safe and a peaceful future for our next generations. So goal number four, quality education. Now let's move to goal number five. Goal number five is gender equality. In fact, it mostly emphasizes on the issues of gender inequality, so we usually call it gender inequality. But the bottom line for gender equality, goal number five, is to achieve gender equality and empower all women and girls. One important thing that you remember if you want to work on goal number five, gender equality, is that mostly emphasizes on empowering the women and females. So why it emphasizes on empowering females? Because even today in underdeveloped countries, women are underemphasized. Women are less represented. Even in job or in other sectors, women are underrepresented. So this calls for a gender equality and empowering the women. So it calls for gender equality and particularly empowering the women in underdeveloped world, likewise the developed world. So this was the goal number five, gender equality, achieving gender equality and empowering the woman. Now moving to goal number six, it advocates about provision of clean and sustainable water. So it calls to ensure availability and sustainable management of water and sanitation for all. So this is also supposed to achieve till 2030 across the globe. So this was goal number 6, clean water and better sanitation system. Now goal number 7, renewable energy. It highlights the need for discovering new sources of energy which are sustainable, which are environment friendly, which are more reliable and which are less vulnerable to our environment. So it calls for renewable sources of energy. Goal number 8, good jobs and economic growth. It claims to promote sustainable, inclusive and good economic growth for the youth, especially for the youth, and also proclaims about employment and decent, respectable work environment for all the employees in underdeveloped as well as in developed world. Goal number 19, it calls for innovation and infrastructure. Like punchline is that build resilient infrastructures, promote inclusive and sustainable industrialization and foster innovation. One thing that you must keep in mind that all those terminologies are subject to environment friendly infrastructure. So this is one thing which is very important. It was innovation and infrastructure. Goal number 10 emphasizes to reduce inequality. Goal number 10 offers to reduce inequality among different countries. Especially it emphasizes to reduce income inequality within and among the countries. Goal number 11, it calls for sustainable cities and communities. This is my second most favorite goal where I am inclined to work. In fact, goal number 11 is sustainable cities and communities. In fact, it gives a model for future cities, like you are watching from the background of my window. So it actually reflects a model of our future cities. So goal number 11, it calls to make our cities and human settlements very inclusive, very safe, very resilient and very sustainable. So there, the models of modern cities, they are changing, and up to 2030 we are supposed to convert our cities into more resilient and more safe and inclusive place for us and for our next generations. Okay, goal number 12, it emphasizes about reasonable consumption. It is also very important and very close to the sustainable. Talks about responsible consumption, and in my own view it is very close to sustainable environment. So it ensures sustainable consumption and production patterns, and they should not degrade the environment in any form of consumption pattern. So up to 2030 we are supposed to make sure that consumption patterns are not harmful for our natural environment. Moving to goal number 13, which is climate action. It calls to take urgent action to combat climate change and its impact by regulating emissions and promoting developments in renewable energy. So it's also talks to move toward a green sustainable environment. Like you might be aware about different climate issues, so it talks to tackle them. Goal number 14 is life below water. So that's due to this goal, I call that sustainable development goals are not only for human beings but also for other creations on the land and even under the water. So this goal emphasizes about conservation and sustainable use of the oceans and seas, and also advocate to conserve the marine life, the life under the seas. So sustainable goals, they are conducive for the marine life as well, not only for human beings. Okay, now moving to goal number 15, which is life on land. Contrary to life underwater, it talks about all the creations which are living on the land in addition to human beings. So it emphasizes to protect, to restore and promote sustainable use of terrestrial ecosystems. So we do not disturb our ecosystem, so we may not disturb the life on land due to our consumption and due to our settlements and other human activities. Goal number 15 talks about life on land and better ecosystem and a healthy biodiversity. Okay, now moving to goal number 16, which talks about peace and justice. This is one of my favorite goal as well. So it talks about provision of inclusive, sustainable justice to all the human races, irrespective of their societies, irrespective of their ethnic affiliations, irrespective of their gender, and irrespective of their social or national affiliations. So it calls for free and fair justice for all and build an effective judicial system for all the people on the land. And it also talks about empowering the institutions which are providing justice. Goal number 17, this is very, very important, and this is a crux of all the 16 goals, all the predecessors. It talks about partnerships for the goals. So if I explain in a nutshell, I'll simply say that goal number 17 emphasizes about collaboration of all the sectors, of all the previous goals, for achieving those sustainable goals. So it talks about strengthen the means of implementation and revitalize the global partnerships for sustainable development. So unless we are not collaborating with each other in all the previous 16 goals, we are not likely to achieve our sustainable development goals till 2030. So goal number 17 in fact highlights the collaboration, the mutual participation, and the representation from all the social societies towards achievement of those sustainable goals. So this was a short video, a brief introduction about all the sustainable development goals. So I hope you might have a clear picture and a better idea about those 17 goals, and this will help you for working on either goal. Thank you very much.